what?
We're squatting.
What? I'm not squatting anyway. She knows that I'm here.
What you're doing is illegal.
She knows that I'm here, sir.
She does not want you in this house.
A home held hostage. The new owner frustrated and frantic.
I tried to work things out with her and it didn't work.
It really is a problem that leaves too many homeowners just feeling helpless and angry.
It's like somebody stole your home. Homeowners having their homes taken over by people that don't have a lease, they don't pay rent, and they have no intention of paying rent. And it turns out getting rid of one is tougher than you may think. Tonight, Help Me Hank investigates.
When I received a call for help from Karen Morgan, she was spent. Her home taken over by a woman who refused to leave. That is until we got involved.
What? Here's the documents. This is not your property. Are you going to get out of this house? At first, she tried to hide. Here are the documents. This is not your home. Then the woman police call a squatter returned to tell her story.
I'm not squatting anyway. She knows that
what
I'm here.
What you're doing is illegal.
Coming up, you'll see how this all plays out. And we'll show you what happened when Detroit police arrived here on scene. Right now, meet Karen Morgan.
I decided to buy a home. A home came up in my old neighborhood, my childhood neighborhood.
Karen purchased this Detroit home last year. The home went up for auction. Her bid won. But she soon discovered an unexpected surprise inside.
I got that bid, so I was excited, oh gosh. And found out someone was staying there.
That's right. Karen discovered this woman was living in her home.
I haven't talked to her. I haven't seen her. She hasn't shown me any paperwork. But she did tell me that she bought the house.
Kalita, otherwise known as Miss B, had made herself at home in Karen's home. And according to Karen, Miss B refused to leave.
I said, I need my house for myself. And she was, oh, okay, well, you know, she acted like she was going to move. And that just never happened.
Even though Karen says she showed the deed and threatened legal action, Miss B stayed put.
So I've been going round and around trying to be nice at the same time and get her to get out of my house, but she's literally refusing.
This woman who Karen says never paid rent, never signed a lease, and who does not own the home is not being forced out by the county to move. Once you take over ownership, it is your responsibility to deal with the squatter and have them removed.
We explained that the property is sold as is. If someone's occupying the property, then it's the obligation of the buyer to address the occupant.
Wayne County Deputy Treasurer Eric Sabre knows the squatter issue is a big one. And some who purchase homes through the auction are stuck to deal with the person inside.
Some individuals say that if I don't keep my property, the treasurer is foreclosed on my property. If I can't live here, no one's going to live here.
Those dealing with the squatter have a few options: legal action, which could take a while, or intervention by police. I let Kalita know when I tracked her down, that was the next step.
We want to make sure that you have somewhere to go.
I have somewhere to go.
If you have somewhere to go, you have to leave the house that's not yours.
I know that. Understand that.
But soon, the big excuses started.
When the lady called me and told me my furnace ready, I'm gone. The lady who's supposed to brought the property, she's never showed me any proper paperwork.
But you know you don't own it.
I know I don't. She came and told me she does. She still hasn't shown me any proper paperwork. I told her I was having an issue with trying to move because it was hard finding a house.
Hours later, Detroit police were called and arrived that day.
I want them out of my house, like, right now.
The moving truck arrived, and soon the woman who had made Karen's home her house was gone.
I'm too happy right now because this has been a long journey.
Now Karen can finally start the work to transform this house, a house in her old neighborhood, one that she hopes to rent to a family who will be able to call this property home.
If Help Me Hank had not been involved, no, she would not have moved out. She would have been buying her time as she's been doing for the past couple of months.
And unfortunately, this happens almost every day in Wayne County. The new homeowner, though, they have options to try to get the person living in the home out. We're going to put all the information you need to know on the Help Me Hank page at clickondetroit.com. I'm Hank Winchester. Help Me Hank. Back to you.